So in this video, I'm going to ask you your opinion about the topic, which is especially, specifically, AD carry diversity versus their niche. And then you can expand it to just champions, period, if you want. But I want to talk about this, because it kind of, at this point, it's kind of like a running meme on my channel. I make an AD carry video every week, and this time, I also am seeing a lot of, you know, diversity talk come back around. So I wanted to kind of address that with my own opinion, and then ask your opinion about that. So starting off, we're going to talk about professional diversity, and how, yes, at the moment, it kind of seems like, you know, Ashe and Sivir, and really any champions that can empower utility, are the only picks being played right now, and because that is exactly true. With top lane carries coming back in, it's all about enabling the top lane and then maybe the mid lane to be able to carry the game. Your job is not necessarily the back seat, but your job is to help with the engage more so than have like the carry threat potential. But if you look at in solo queue, for example, I believe as it stands, Jinx actually has the second highest win rate amongst AD carries. That's not really a utility AD carry, that's somebody that you want to carry the game on. And what I mean by champion diversity versus champion niche is, if you remember earlier in the season, you know, Misfortune was a viable and power pick at one point. You know, Kog'Maw was a viable and power pick at one point. Lucian was for a while. And even now, even though it's more about Sivir and Ashe, you still see Jhin because his ult can kind of help with utility, and with the armor pin build, makes each bullet hurt like a lot. So when you see things like that, I think diversity, it gets a little bit muddy, because I think some people see diversity as something that should be viable all year round, and not everything's viable all year round, so diversity is not really there. Versus, on the other hand, why I say niche is because I feel some of these champions that you don't really see too much, like Jinx, for example, she's won five games out of 15 professionally across the four major regions and the LMS. But in the games she's won, at least in some of them, it's because they built the comp around Jinx. They built it so that Jinx could succeed, and when you do that, when you play to a champion's identity, they're still very powerful. So when you look at a champion like Jinx, for example, you play a Protect the Jinx comp right now, she's still going to do work. But if you do something like in the EULCS, they had a Jinx game where the comp was kind of three different comps. They had a Laoi top that wanted a split push, they kind of had some poke champions, and then they had some AoE team fighting champions, and it just didn't mesh really well. And so the argument though on the caster's desk was kind of Jinx wasn't really even meta. And yes, kind of, because it's not utility, right? That's kind of what the meta is right now. But on top of that, when the comp is like three different ways like that, or in Oceania, when you have a Azir that dies like six times and doesn't get a single kill, it's kind of how it works. But furthermore, I think that a niche might be even more important than diversity, because what it means is, as like a Jinx player myself, let's say I'm a Jinx fan, right? That means if I'm seeing a Jinx game, it's because that team wanted to play Jinx, so I might be saying like the highest level and best of Jinx play, even if she's not picked like every game. And while the argument of diversity isn't necessarily against that, it's about just seeing like the same comp every game, I think that has to just do, again, with the meta. The meta is always changing, the meta is always different, and I don't think everything can always be viable all the time in the meta. Will the meta shift by worlds? I don't know at this point, but I think that's what I personally believe is the difference between diversity and niche. So that's just my opinion on it, and now this is the part where I ask your opinion on it, as well as saying that's all for this video for me. If you watched this far, thank you for watching. Life is full of a lot of kinks, so I don't know which video will be next. So until next time, take care from the Fire Good Eye FS.